unengaged lately in my channel, and I really do apologize for that. I just have a lot going on, and I'm not sure what the fuck is up with my camera, but the quality looks really like blurry or something, and I cleaned off my camera. Okay, well, this is better, but I know some of you guys don't like the brightness of my videos, but I feel like it looks shitty when I don't put it up. This is the lowest brightness, so. Shit. Okay. So, today is fucking November 10th.
He definitely could have cut more.
still take every day, and I have not had a complication with any deficiencies. Like, a lot of people after bariatric surgery, they sometimes have issues with not enough of something. Like, they lack something in their blood, you know? Like, levels can be thrown off if you're not eating properly. But the whole year and a half since I've had the surgery, my levels and blood work have been consistently good. If I eat this on an empty stomach, though, I'll throw up. Relationships, nowhere near that, but it's getting a little toxic. I still have not used the Fifine microphone. I still have not opened the shit, bro. It's literally sitting on my dresser, but I really want to do my college story time, like love triangle story time. I would really like that. Because speaking of toxic, I guess I just got this shit down packed, so. And I don't know, it just don't be as crazy as it used to be, because we have really, really good kids right now, so. Well, let me tell you about that too, my job. What was I doing? Oh, I wanted to tell you how much this water bottle was, because look at all this shit I have coming. Sparkled all over it, and lunch bag because I literally just used that for the wedding that I went to over the summer, and I've used that for like years, like for special events or whatever. Said for them traveled with like 25 of them or something. It was super emotional. Like, I always, if you are like loyal to my channel, then you know how I feel about the kids and how like my heart just like, I can't help but to love them. So, with that being said, I think the fact that like I'm starting to not enjoy my job as much is because like I want to get a better, like, basically, you know how I've been like searching for another job and like just not, I don't know how to explain it, but like my joy for the job has just like, because that was the second time of like losing all of the kids at one time, which is just so much more traumatic than like kids gradually leaving. I don't know, but what the fuck? I don't know. I've just been like losing my joy lately of the job, and ever since we got kids back, I haven't been like interacting with the kids as much because I told myself like I'm gonna try to like, sorry guys, I'm like actually sick. Like, three people at my job just tested positive for COVID. And I'm so stuffed up, but thank God for nose spray. But my nose is like, every time I take nose drops, my nose is like itchy. I like start sneezing and shit. I'm so sorry. I just feel like blah the past couple of days, but hopefully I don't have COVID. I'm literally annoying. What the fuck was I talking about? Oh yeah, I'm trying to like cut back. Like, I told myself when we get kids back, I'm really seriously going to fall back. Like, I'm not good. Like, I'm gonna interact, but I'm not gonna be how I was before. Like, now I'm more on like my supervising shit. Like, I'm like supervising the staff, the kids as well, but like I don't interact with them as much as I used to. Just because it's so emotionally, like, I don't know. Like, I just feel like I was getting too invested sometimes, and you really have to keep your boundaries or whatever. Like, we had like a whole boundaries training and stuff, but I just told myself, like, yeah, I kind of want to leave this job soon, so like, let me not, when we get kids back, let me just not be how I was before. Like, let me not interact with them as much as I did before, which is honestly like sad, because 2 nights ago this girl was like, she complimented my nails and she was like, I forget what she said. I was like, oh, you're leaving tomorrow, right? And she was like, you know that? And I was like, yeah. And she was like, you do you know my name? And I was like, yeah. And I said it and she was like, God, you know my name? And then the girl next to her was like, you don't know my name? And I said her name and they were like, oh my God, Mies, you know? And honestly, before that day, I didn't know either of their names. I'm not finna front row. This was yesterday, I think, yeah. Or 2 days ago, I don't know. But before that day, I really didn't know their names, and they've been there for weeks. Like, I'm the person that the whole time I've worked at this shelter, I always know every single kid's name. Like, every single kid's name. And ever since, like, I've been doing this job, since the kids came back last month or whenever the fuck it was, I don't know everyone's name. And I just didn't care to learn, which is so bad. Like, I asked, like, a couple times, but, like, I just haven't been interacting with them like that. So that made me like really sad yesterday when she said that, or no, 2 days ago, I don't fucking know. I was like, oh my God. And like, she was so happy that I knew her name, and I was just like, what the fuck? And I had only learned their names because the one girl was about to leave the next day, and the other girl, a case manager, needed to talk to her. So that's the only reason I learned their names, but that made me really sad. Like, that kind of made me be like, damn, Samantha, like, come on. don't even know everyone's name. Like, I've never, ever, everyone would always say, like, Samantha, how do you remember everyone's name? But that's just how I am. But I don't know, I'm just like, damn, I gotta cut the cord. I gotta, like, not be so involved. But that made me really sad, because then I was, like, sitting with her and the girl for dinner. So, like, nobody else was there. It was just us and them. And then the girl that I said had been at the shelter for a long time and is still there. She's leaving soon. But she was, like, they're all teenagers, by the way. But the girl was talking to me, and she was like, oh, my gosh, you talked to me the day before I'm leaving. And I was like, that's so sad. I was like, you've never talked to me before either. And she was like, you're always serious, like, eres muy serio siempre. I'm like, no, what the fuck? I was like, yo. She's like, see? I'm like, what? And then I called over the other girl who, like, knows me very well since she's been there for so long and left and came back. And I was like, bro, I said, hey, tía, yo muy serio siempre. Yo muy serio siempre. Y a ti, Samantha, no, Samantha, no. And, I don't know, we just talked some more and more and more, and she was like, at the end of the conversation, she was like, eres muy divertido, or whatever, like, you're really fun, and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, that's so sad that, like, she thinks that I walk around serious, which is kind of so, like, it makes me so sad that, like, the kids think right now, because that's so not me. But I've just been more focused on, like, my job and not necessarily interacting with them as much. Like, guys, I interact with them, I fucking talk to them, I do their intakes, like, their initial intakes, like, you know, we laugh, we joke, I make sure that they're comfortable, blah, blah. I'm not, like, a fucking heartless bitch, but I don't, like, first of all, my role, you're not supposed to have super, like, a lot of contact, as much as the direct staff does, obviously, because they're the ones with them every second. But yeah, that made me really, like, sad. So yeah. So then today, like I was saying, with the activity for the Thanksgiving theme or whatever, I was, like, going around, like, actually trying to talk to the kids some more. You know, I always ask them, like, to practice their English, stuff like that. And I'm just, like, interacting with them more. And I could tell that they were, like, really happy. Because I guess, like, I just don't interact with them as much anymore, guys. I don't know. It's really not for nothing. It's not because I don't want to. It's just, like, I don't want to. I need to start, like, pulling back my feelings or whatever. But tonight, that shit went out the window, because during the activity, I started crying. One of the guys, he's kind of older, but he came to my birthday dinner. We're really close. He started crying, too, because I went over to him. I was like, oh, my God, I keep crying. He was like, me, too. We're both, like, super fucking emotional. Like, nobody else cried, just us. And I could not hold it in, guys, because I was reading. I was going around, like I said, and I was reading some of the things that they wrote. And yes, although I can't understand every single word, I pretty the fuck can understand every single thing that they wrote. There were, like, a few words here and there, but, bro, I literally can fucking read that shit now. What started it was this one girl wrote, gracias a Dios por guarda a mí en el camino. Y yo me dije, Because, like, you don't know what they could have been through. Oh my god, my hair is standing up. Look at the goosebumps. Can you see? Yeah. Oh, fuck me. Yeah. Oh my god, bro. I could not hold it in. I just started, like, the tears just started coming. And I was like, oh my god. I was like, qué bonito. Qué lindo. That's so, like, beautiful. And a couple other ones that I read, the guy that I was just talking about, he was telling me, he was like, Samantha, this boy just wrote that he's grateful for the shoes. He's grateful for zapatos. Bruh, and then one kid wrote that he's grateful that he gets to watch television. That he's never watched television before and he's super grateful that he gets to watch TV. And then another one, like, I was literally just going around and, like, the tears, I just kept having to go like this. But, like, a lot of the kids saw it anyway. And, you know, I think that was a side that a lot of the kids didn't really expect from me, like, because, like I said, I've been kind of holding back what the fuck is going on. Here ain't all peaches and cream, but like is, like, not important. Like, if you were to be there, like, looking at these kids and just hearing, some of the things that they've been through, it's just like, how could anyone's heart ever say no to these kids? How could anyone ever look at these kids and say, you don't deserve an opportunity here? Yeah, it was just amazing to see on every single person's paper that they were so grateful for the opportunity to be here. Literally, some of them said exactly that. They were all kind of worded differently, but the same exact thing. Some kid, a teenager, he wrote he's grateful to learn about new traditions here, like holidays traditions for the Thanksgiving. I don't know, it was just really fucking, it was just, tonight was amazing. And then I was like putting some stuff away after the craft, and I came across like this huge stack of like paintings that just regular canvases, and I had decorated the hallway months and months ago with paintings like this from the kids. And I don't know where this stack of paintings came from. I don't know why the fuck, like, they just randomly fucking appeared on the shelf. I'm like, these are fucking mad old, but I was looking at them and I started seeing like the names on the back of them, and it was literally like the kids that we had to evacuate. And I'm just like, oh my god, like, it was just reminding me of all the kids, like, all the names, all the kids that had left. And I don't know, it was just tonight, really, like, made me remember that my purpose is not to make a ton of money. My purpose is, I need to remind myself, my purpose is to help others. There is nothing in this world more important. Seriously, guys, there's nothing more important, nada más importante de este. So yeah, recuérdate este siempre. So yeah, I don't know, I need to fucking stop, bro. But I don't know, I needed that tonight. I really needed that because I've been so like clocked out from attaching myself emotionally to this job, but like, I need to stop doing that because that's who I am. I get attached, not attached, but yeah, kind of. But like, how can I enjoy? No wonder I haven't enjoyed the job, because I haven't been allowing myself to embrace the kids like I always have. First of all, my heart. It's so fucking stupid, I know, guys. Like, I'm literally 5. But, bro, come on. Are we kidding me? Are we kidding me? Okay, perfect. Esos es mi favoritas. Mira, oh my fucking god. Like, these are probably my favorites of my fucking lifetime. Y'all ready? Are y'all ready? Bro, what? Super heavy, but like, is it worth it? Absolutely. I mean, I haven't tried them on, but they're heavy. They're not like OD. I have some that are OD. Like fucking ornaments. But these are not that bad. These, oh my fucking god, dog. I cannot fucking wait to wear these. I definitely wouldn't wear these, like, I was gonna say on a normal basis, but I probably would. Not my brother coming in at 4 in the morning. Steven! You wanna say hi to the people?
Where's Kevin?
Kevin left. Oh, I'll tell y'all about Kevin.
I miss Kevin.
You miss that little fucking bitch. I don't fucking miss him. Yes, I said that I quit, and it's the truth, but every time I see my brother, I hit it.
She's a liar. She didn't quit. She's a fraud.
Why is my neck so fucking... So I don't have any pants on, and he, like, put his arm, like, around me, and he fell. He felt, like, my bare back. He was like, what the fuck? And he said it was wet a little bit. And I said, that's because me and my bae were doing a little something on the telephone. Sorry. But this tastes really good. Talk to the people. What's that? Oh. Kia, 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 kia. What do you want, pendejo? Que quieres, pendejo? Estás borracho.
Sí.
¿Tú sabes la significa? ¿De qué me dice? ¿Qué de yo me dije? Do you know what I said?
Sí.
Are you drunk?
No.
You're not?
A little bit.
Alright, one more.
I just dropped my bottle.
What? Hold on, I gotta go, y'all. Hold on. Bro, my brother's fucking feet literally fucking reeked. Like, I told him, like, we were just sitting here, like, geeking about it. The fact that the scent is fucking lingering in my room is disgusting. Like, that's really gross, but the reason I got this is because it would go good with, like, some of my Barbie outfits. Like, it's pink. Sale for like $2 or something, but the likelihood of me ever wearing this is getting very low. to say all thing, but still I spent $390 all in one time. And the fact that I can't, I think there was like two things that were qualified to return out of that much stuff, bro, for real. And the two things that I could return, I wanted. So I seriously have a huge bag of shit of stuff that I need to like take pictures of and sell on Poshmark and Facebook. I mean, not Facebook, Mercari. But that broke my heart. That I cannot return all of that shit that I fucking spent money on. Like, what? Is so goddamn big. I don't fucking know, but yeah. How beautiful. And I'm so much better now at wearing heels. Like, I've always been the type to never want to wear heels. Like, I hate them. Hated them. But it's so much easier the more you wear them. And I don't wear them often, but like, a lot more often than I used to, so. They have this square top. Rhinestones, and then it's fuzzy. Fuzzy, 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 fuzzy. Super gaudy, super me. And I believe these are on sale. I don't remember how much, but always like fucking follow me every fucking where. And then every time it would be time to like go in the cage. Like yesterday I literally had to chase him at midnight and like trap him with like this wooden gate because he would not fucking come. It was just too much. It was too much. His dog food smelled disgusting. He was mad fucking strong. Every time I take him out, he's like pulling me in the leash. I was just so fucking, bro. I'm so terrible. My mom was like, you're literally psychotic. She was like, you're so mean. I'm like, bro, he has to go. Like, I'm never watching anyone else's dog, like, ever again. I'm so serious, bro. That shit is beyond dead. I need to fucking mop the floor. Anyway, that's Kevin. His name's Kevin. But then I got these boots. Yes, bitch. They are pointy. I don't really like pointy, but I don't know. Chunky. Stilettos and like thin heels. No, I'm only good with thick heels. But these are over the knee boots, which I love. But these are like a what the fuck? Okay. What is on my hands? Entonces, ¿qué es ese? Maquillaje. Yo supongo, yo no sé. Oops. God damn it. I better be able to get this out. Jesus Christmas. Yeah, these are also over the knee ones. I really wanted over the knee boots to cover up my cellulite legs for the most part. First of all, what is that? Okay. Like, stuff fucking clings to it and shit.